Eight racks to two. We need a break. Lose with that white ball, but look at this rack. This rack is such a difficult rack right now. The one, the four, the six, the five, the nine, they're all sitting there in like a semicircle. Greg Jenkins has got the longest shot. He's got to play some kind of a safety here. I think he's just thinking about taking a 1-3 combo. That would be a very ambitious shot. This is a very difficult rack looking at it right now. It's not open at all. What can Greg do here?
Maybe keep off that one. And behind it.
Oh, what a shot. What a straight in the hole. Fantastic shot. Didn't even touch his sides.
Wow.
Through. Lovely shot, Greg.
You know, I have a little feeling that Greg just wants to run on the balls here. He's been sitting down for a couple of racks.
I think he's got up out of his chair.
But this is not an easy rack to run. Unless he plays a 4-9 combination. Let's see what he does. Two balls out of the way, seven. Oh, well, he's got this ball in the middle as well.
That's a fantastic track.
I'll be very, very impressed.
And sometimes when you get a bit tired of sitting in your seat, you know, somebody's dominating and you get out of your seat, you're like, you know, I've got a point to prove. I think that shot was what he wanted to do and make that point there.
That's his four player, he's just opened up the entire rack. It looks like a real critical rack to run.
Absolutely.
And when, I guess the opponent's going to punish you for this. And you're eight racks at two down, race to 11.
At first I thought there might be a bit of safety going on in this game, but you know what, just a testament to fabulous players like these guys, just opening it up little by little, you know, and it looks like it's going to take the rack from this. I mean, to clear up from there, I mean, you know, when they're spaced so awkwardly, like you said before.
Yeah, he hasn't cleared up yet, but I mean, this is exactly what he had to do to get himself back in this game.
I couldn't get cleared up with a vacuum cleaner, from there, you know. amazing players. Well done, Greg.
Well, I'll tell you what, considering the conditions right now when you're down 8 racks to 2 and race to 11, and considering how the balls are laying, Greg Jenkins, this is one of the best racks I've ever seen run in my life. Awesome work, man. Well done.
Wow. So he's stepping up in his love. I mean,
this deserves a wild. I want the wow.
I'm in business, and I'm playing well. Nice break there. He's got a ball for break. He's got two balls for break.
He broke a man five in a row against Luke Hoff in the match before this. There's no reason why I can't do it right now. More than capable. He's got all the ability in the world. And Greg Jenkins has got a very, very good temperament.
I was playing in a competition, excuse me, down at Wembley, and a while back, with Keith the Pigeon Cole.
I know Keith.
Keith the Pigeon Cole, quick shout out. And I was playing Greg, and Keith said, "Do you know you're playing now?" I said, "No." Because I just recently got into the scene, you know. He said,
You're still wet behind the ears, right?
"I don't know who you're playing." I said, "No." He said, "This guy's one of the best players in the country." And I was 2-0 up in a race of three against him.
And then what happened?
he beat me 3-2.
maybe Keith should have kept his mouth quiet.
I think he should have. He took the wind out of my sails there when he said that, you know. But nice shot there.
Yeah, it's funny that you make a very good point there. Some players, when they're playing people that they know that they're better than, they just play, you know, they open up their wings, as we say, and they just play away. But sometimes when they play someone who of a name like Greg Jenkins, they do buckle, or they think, "Oh my God, I'm playing with, you know, one of Australia's best players." You know, you're right. At the end of the day, I know this sounds very simple for everybody out there, but you got to play the ball.
Absolutely. I mean, I had my confidence with me, you know, and I was firing on all cylinders. But as soon as he said that, I'm not scared to admit, but I think that made me a little bit scared, you know? And I thought, oh no, this guy's, you know, this guy's really something. And maybe, I can't remember the games. I think he probably played brilliantly and won the games rightfully, or that might have knocked a bit of, wind out my sails, and I might have kind of got a little bit less confident. But
yeah, take it from me, it's a good feeling to beat someone who was favoured to beat you. And it's a way, everyone has to do that to get better. You've got to beat people who you are favoured to beat you. But in your mind, though, when you're playing, you've got to believe you're favourite.
Absolutely.
Or else you'll never win.
Absolutely. And Greg, I think Greg's got himself to put that mindset, because he's two
last. Like I said, Greg is more than capable of breaking running four or five breaks, isn't he?
And he's going to bring us back to 8-4. I don't really know how we go yet, but he's got a fight with him.
Check out his break. There's a control break.
Make a ball this time. Putting the one in the corner, the middle pocket.
Young Vinny Cal, I just realised his shirt matches exactly the 5-ball. Same colour as the 5-ball, bright orange.
Absolutely. I think he's cycling home tonight. That's all he's got up for, right?
How's that he sees it, man?
Just joking. Sorry, Dad.
You have a two-man combination here? Look.
He's looking at it.
Yeah, he's going to show some. Now he's playing a point.
There's two ways he could do that, I suppose. Play the two onto the nine, or white off the two onto the nine. But he's left himself all right. A little bit unfortunate for Greg, that could have left him a combo there, I think.
Yeah, if the 9-ball was lower, he could have definitely played a combination here. Yeah, he can. But Greg's now going to play an interesting safety shot, I believe. Let's see what he comes up with.
Side there, which made the white come back straight off the cushion.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't believe he was going for a 9-ball. I think he was going for a safety shot like this.
I think Timmy's definitely going to play a bit safe from here.
He's gone for the 9-ball. He's gone for the 9.
He has not.
Wow, no, he played the 9 there, my man.
Unlucky.
Vinny played a safety shot and the white ball for 9 there. And he's so good with the white ball. He knows where the white's going. He knows how to play off rail. It's a great shot. I mean, you can't play 9-ball, Vinny.
Did he say that? He didn't say that.
He said something once that people doubt me that I can play 9-ball, but I tell you what, no one doubts how good Vinny is. See, Vinny's not only a good player, but he's also a very good mentor. He's got a very good temperament. He's always positive, and he's just a lovely guy to hang out with. Funny guy.
Whoever said that about you, Vinny, really? Because before we started commentating, Barry and Kimo,
Barry and Kimo say?
Before we started commentating, Barry and Kimo were having a little chuckle with themselves about the fact that a joke, obviously, that you couldn't play 9-ball. Because obviously somebody said that. And maybe you said that somebody said that. But, mate, you're one of the best players around, you know? And whatever would that. The fact that you can play, be in your mind or anybody's mind.
Who cares what people say anyway, mate?
Oh, yeah, man. What a fantastic player. I mean,
he's won our straight. He's won our 8-ball event we had here in New South Wales a little while ago. There were 87 runners in that event, and to win that event, Vinny had to beat. You ready? You love this. Vinny had to beat along the way Sean Buck, which he did on the hill. Yeah. He had to beat David Realty, Stuart Lawler in the final. I mean, that's three of Australia's best players right there. He had a very difficult draw, and he beat them all. That was our 8-ball on 9-4. He won our 9-ball event, I think, that we had at Wembley as well. And I think he might have won a 10-ball event as well, I'm not sure. But he's an awesome player. And he's
a fantastic player. He's absolutely remarkable.
Yeah. Now he's 9 racks to 4. Richard Evans, by the way, I want to say hello to Richard Evans. Richard Evans, as you know, has Oz Billiards. He sat here racking the balls for us, and he sells cues, he sells bags, he sells everything. And he's a hell of a nice guy as well. Very knowledgeable pool player.
He's a very nice guy. I'm trying to get in contact with him real soon to maybe get a cue and tips and buy a case or a bag off him. A new cue that I bought with Dave Rolgen.
You bought a Lucasian habit, didn't you?
I did. I don't think Dave's ever used it, actually. But he sold me a nice cue. My first cue, I've been playing with a pub cue last season. I got to the finals of the Gold Cup. With a pub cue.
I said to you that if you buy yourself your own cue, your games can go through the roof. You're already an awesome player, but I can't believe you're so good playing with a rack cue all the time.
I don't mind playing with a rack cue, to be honest. But what I've noticed about getting a new cue is the amount of action and getting the white ball.
Yeah.
I should have owned one before, but you know, as you say, look at that. That's gorgeous. See that? That was absolutely beautiful. Yeah. I've got the one as well, just to
make sure.
Just to take the piss, you know. Brilliant.
Well, really, right now, Jenkins is in. He's really up against it right now because he is two racks away from taking in this tournament. And he's got to make balls at the break. I mean, when your opponent's two racks away, you've got to play pretty much perfect to win.
And what we saw earlier with the Muzz comeback, you know, against Danny Stone. We've seen a bit of a comeback here off Greg, and he's not far away from, bringing this back to, you know, bringing this back to evens. He's taken a few frames back. He looks like he might have, I think he's rattled one there. He looks like he might have not the wind out of Vinny's sails, but.
Oh, Vinny played a combination shot and was trying to hold the white ball as well. And did maybe pinch in the pocket a little bit too much there. But yeah, you're right. Jenkins has got an opportunity now to bring another frame back. And this is a big shot, this combination. Also, the white ball going behind the black.
He's made it into his combination.
I don't know, mate. It really is hard to say from that camera angle. I think he's going to play safe. I don't know what he's doing here.
He's going for it, but
I think he's got it. No, he hasn't.
Nice cut there, Vinny. Nice cut.
Big shot here. Seven's not exactly in a favourable position now with a nine ball blocking its par. This is not an easy pot either. It's quite uncharacteristic. It is normally so smooth with the white piece.
It's got a firmer stroke on now.
For most players, yeah.
For most, but. Unfortunately,
yeah. Okay, well, it really is a pleasure to be commentating for Football TV. I mean, we've done a lot of matches in the past, and for Q-Ball, we've done live matches, we've done post matches, we've done edited matches, we've done more. And it really is, nine ball for me is my favorite game to commentate on. It's the easiest one to follow. You know that after the floor, the center will be next. And it's just a privilege and a pleasure to be commentating for Q-Ball TV. And I always love it when I get asked to do things like this.
After the four, the seven ball would be next.
Well, in this situation, yes, because there's a couple of balls missing.
Oh, sorry, Barry. Unlucky there, Vinny. Unlucky. He's throwing his hands down. He's not happy about that one.
Do you know who's happy about that one, though?
The man at the table right now. But
right now. These shots are tricky as well when he's on the
pocket. There's only two guys to learn if they're right here, but you're watching them right now.
Not only pattern play, I mean, but also temperament. How to conduct yourself on a table when you're in the match. Fred Jenkins, you don't know if he's in front or behind. From the way he talks, the way he talks. And I love that about his game.
Absolutely.
He's not only is he a gentleman off the table, but he's also he conducts himself very well, whether he's winning or whether he's losing. And that, to me, is a real good sign of, you know, when you're competing, your internal personality does come out. I'm a bit of a chicken, personally, and sometimes when I'm losing, you see that I go for the chicken shot. I play too much safe, or I got a half player shot, you know what I mean? And sometimes I'm feeling really confident, I'm just not good at it. But, yeah, I don't even know what I'm trying to say with this, but I'm saying Greg Jenkins is a gentleman on and off the court.
Absolutely.
You know, you can get beat on the table, but you can always walk away looking like a champion.
To be honest, Barry, I must back you up there. The way he conducts himself as a person and as a player is quite beautiful, you know. He's very polite. He's always off willing to offer information, you know, if you ask him, a bit of a hint.
Yeah.
You know, I was at the Cue Ball event and I talked to him about the tables and he went off for a few minutes telling me about his tables and the diamond shop tables at the time.
Yeah.
They kind of teach us kind of personality that you like to talk to.
He comes with maturity as well. He's a very mature person. I mean, he is older than most people. He's 49 years old.
Right.
But I think it's maturity.
He's a kind of father figure in the pool world, you know? You ask him a question, he's happy to respect that. That was a well-asked question. And
oh, my God. What happened there?
What a...
He used a knuckle for position? That was awesome.
That was fantastic.
Just to get the pot cut like that was awesome.
Nice thin cut.
Wow, that shot there was really top of my mind. But he's just like, getting on with it. Like
little glance, reminded me of Ronnie Sullivan there. You know, that Ronnie O'Sullivan, that little quick turn. While he's on the move, he does that quick little glance to the other ball while he's walking. And then gets down, pots it. That's a great shot.
Vinny Calabrese on the hill, 10 racks to 6. There's one more rack to secure the victory. He parked the white ball nicely this time, but again, no ball off the break. No friends at the table. He's got to be feeling pretty confident now. He's 4 racks ahead.
Absolutely.
Many times. He just ran out green light track earlier. That potting skills there. Jenkins here, just a 7.
Left himself a bit unlucky there. He's going to be on the plane. It would have been nice to leave himself over a little bit longer or a little bit shorter.
I wonder
that
if he can come off thin off the 2 ball here and make the 4.
I think he might be able to. If not, a safety shot. Maybe. Oh, nice. And bringing the blue into play there to slot past that pretty cool.
Wow.
There's 4 frames behind, but it was a great shot and his killer instincts coming out a bit now and really wants to claw his way back. And a comeback, I mean, you can never write off a good comeback like this because, as we saw earlier, with Muzz being so far down for Danny, he came back and took the lead at one point.
Well, absolutely, that's why I like winner break format in 9 ball. You can never count anyone out.
No, absolutely.
Someone can break and run 4 in a row. Out.
Coming back from 5 frames behind and then taking the lead. I wouldn't put it past them, really.
But yeah, when your opponent's on the hill, you have to have him in perfect. You've got to break, make sure he falls off the break, land on the ground.
Oh my word, I didn't even know that was on.
Slam that.
That was fantastic. Well done, Greg, that was an awesome cut. I thought it would have been going for the double there.
That was awesome. Speechless.
even look at that shot.
This is what I was saying. When your opponent's on the hill, you got a break perfect level of one. Now he's just dry broken.
Absolutely.
And I mean, I wouldn't bet against Vinny on the rack right here, would you?
Right. I wouldn't. Just going back to that last shot there, you know, some shots watching on the Cooper TV here, or watching a shot on TV, you can't quite tell where the ball is, and you would think,
that was a thin shot.
That cut was never on.
That's
know?
Why he slammed that. That was
but, thin. Obviously, you know, if we maybe were to look at the table, if we were there on the day, you know, we would get
the cut. Yeah, players of this caliber as well, they make the game look ridiculously easy.
Absolutely.
You go out there, you grab yourself acoustic, and you shoot some racks, you'll see that the game isn't as easy as what they make it look. Even this rack here, the whole key of this rack was getting on this four ball nicely, and really he's making it look too simple.
Player of his caliber, I mean, why maybe, you know, he was born with the name Calabrese, which is very much like Calabre, you know? Kind of like the time that Arsene Wenger.
You ever watched his brother play, Arsene Calabrese?
No, I haven't.
He's awesome as well, man. I watched him play. He's awesome. He's really smooth.
Yes.
His brother has the Australian record for most break and runs, the Oceania record. 7 break and runs in a row.
No way.
Why?
I remember when I remember when Arsene Wenger got the job at Arsenal. You know, he's been the best manager they've ever had.
Yeah.
And his name is virtually, without two letters or two letters added, his name is Arsenal. You know what I mean? I said, this has got to be an omen. This guy's going to be great. You know, he's been the best manager they've ever had. You know,
yeah.
I mean, so maybe that's like Vinny.
Big jump
you know?
Shot here from Greg.
He's got the name Calibre as his surname. You know,
Calibre is. That's why I went wrong. I got the wrong surname.
Me too. Why can't Williams mean something good, eh?
Mark Williams was still a player. World champion last day.
Oh, what a shot
from Vinny.
Lovely shot, Vinny.
Behind the six ball. That was an awesome shot. What's he going to do here? He's going to swerve it. If he swerves this, he's going to swerve it. Yeah, why not? I'm Vinny Calabrese. I'm going to swerve the ball. And make it look bloody easy. Look at this.
You know.
Look at this. And position.
Simple, really.
Oh my goodness. You got any Kleenex?
What?
I am too excited about that shot. Wow, and that's to win.
Wow.
Wow.
Keep your eye on me, ladies and gentlemen. I'll tell you what, I'll make it easy for you. I'll wear an orange.
Before he pots his two balls, I want to say thank you very much for commentating with me tonight, man. Because he's going to know this. Thank you very much, Cue Ball TV. Thank you very much for you at home for watching and helping make Cueball TV and our sport happen. Thanks, guys.
Thanks for having me, Barry. A great shot there.
Well done, Vinny. Congratulations, Greg.
Unlucky, Greg.
Thanks, my man.
Two great players.